Hello, this is Connie Belden, and in the last video, we calculated the net cash flows from operating activities. In this video, we will take a look at investing activities and financing activities. So let's go back to the other information that is given. Letter A says investments sold for $5,500 cash, and letter B says equipment and land that was purchased for cash, and none was disposed during the year. These two items will affect the investing activities. So let's start with investments sold for cash, $5,500. That means we sold some investments, and we collected from that sale in cash $5,500. So our cash flows for investing activities increased by $5,500. Now, for the equipment and land, we need to take a look at the change in those accounts. Land here went from zero last year to $20,000 this year. So that means that we purchased with cash $20,000 in land. So that will decrease our cash flows by $20,000 as we paid out $20,000 in cash for land. For equipment last year was $10,000. This year it's $15,000. So if you take the difference, that means we bought $5,000 more of equipment with cash. So therefore, that will decrease my cash for investing activities by $5,000. If I add these three investing activities together, I get a negative $19,500 because I've spent more in cash than I took in cash. So therefore, we call it a net cash flow used for investing activities instead of from, since it is a negative number. Next, let's take a look at cash flows from financing activities. Letter C says common stock was issued for cash. Letter E says dividends declared was $3,000. Both of these items will affect the financing activities. So let's look at letter C first. Common stock was issued for cash. So we'll go back to the financials. We'll start by looking at common stock. Notice it went from $70,000 to $100,000. So therefore, that's a difference of $30,000 of common stock that was sold. So therefore, $30,000 in cash was coming in from the common stock at its par value. But notice that when you look at the next row here, the paid in capital from sale of common stock, it went from $10,000 to $15,000. It went up by $5,000. So that means we sold it above par for $5,000. Therefore, the amount of cash coming in from that sale of common stock is the $30,000, the amount at par value, plus the $5,000. The amount we sold it for above par value. So we collected $35,000, that's an increase in cash flow, from the sale of common stock. And notice I did make a note to the side that that's for the $30,000 increase in common stock plus the $5,000 increase in paid in capital. The other item that affects our financing activities is letter E. Dividends declared $3,000. Now that says declared. It didn't say paid. So therefore, if it's dividends declared, we need to determine the amount that was actually paid. We know dividends declared was $3,000. If I take a look at my dividends payable account, the beginning balance, or the balance at the end of 2014, is $2,000. The ending balance in dividends payable, or at the end of 2015, is $1,000. And then remember, I declared $3,000. So I do show the calculation here below. I want to take the $2,000 beginning balance for dividends payable. That's the amount at the end of 2014. Add the $3,000 that letter E said was declared. That puts you at $5,000. But subtract the $1,000 ending dividends payable, the amount at the end of 2015. So therefore, the amount of dividends paid is actually $4,000. Since we paid those dividends, that would be a decrease in cash flows of $4,000. So I have an increase of $35,000, subtract out the decrease of $4,000, and my net cash flows provided by financing activities is $31,000. Next, I will finish it out by calculating my increase or decrease in cash. In this case, I have more cash coming in that I spent, so therefore it will be an increase in cash. And I'll calculate that by taking $52,000 cash flows from operating activities, subtract $19,500 cash flows used for investing activities, and add $31,000 cash flows provided by financing activities. So therefore, I will have an increase in cash of $63,500. Now, to prove that equals my ending cash balance, I'll go back to the balance sheet and look at my cash at the beginning of the year. That will be my cash balance at the end of 2014. That is given at $43,000. I will bring down the $43,000. I will add the increase in cash of $63,500 plus the cash at the beginning of the year of $43,000. And my ending cash should be $106,500. If I go back to the income statement and look at my cash balance for 2015, it does show $106,500. So I do equal out, and that's a way you can check yourself before using any Check My Works. Thank you very much.